Hi everyone, in this short video I'm going to discuss the application of compound conditions in if functions. You know, basic if function, it has one logical test and result is given in two parameters. But if you want to incorporate more logical test to your if function, you can do it so by adding AND functions or OR functions to your IF functions. So accordingly, before talking about this complicated scenario, we will first discuss what is AND function means alone, right? So what is the role of AND functions? Okay, AND function can be applied to test several logical conditions. You can test up to 255 logical conditions. If all the logical conditions satisfied, this function will give you the result as true. Otherwise, you will get the result as false. So this is similar to Boolean operations, right? We discussed Boolean operator usually gives you the result as true or false. So this AND function will test lot of conditions. And if all the conditions satisfy, all the arguments are true, then the function will give you the result as true. Otherwise, result will be false. So we'll now try this with Excel, how this will work. Right, here you are given a student database in which you can see the names of the students. And these students are from different universities, and they are from different faculties and from different departments. Now let's say we want to identify students from USJ management faculty and from the Department of Accounting. So accordingly, we want to satisfy three conditions. University should be USJ, faculty should be management, and the department should be accounting. So according, since you want to satisfy all the conditions, we can apply AND function. So we know the syntax of an AND function. We can do this. We can apply AND function like this. Write a formula with equal sign and say AND. And we need to ensure university must be USJ. At the same time, you want to ensure the faculty must be equal to management, and the department, one more thing, and the department must be equal to accounting, and just enter. So you can now drag it to other cells in the database, and you can see which student satisfied all the conditions. So you can see for Bandara, he's from USJ, Faculty of Management, Department of Accounting, and there's another one, Silva, from USJ, Management Faculty, and from the Department of Accounting. Okay, now you can see this AND function gives you the result as false or true, right? True or false. If you want to get another alternative result, let's say yes or no, you can do it so by combining this AND function with IF function. So it's very simple. You can just cut this AND function. Whole AND function can be, you can copy or cut, and write down IF function. If, and for the logical condition, you can give the whole AND function that you have copied. If you satisfy these conditions, if you satisfy all these conditions as a single condition, you can say yes. otherwise no. So you can now see you have just in front of only for two students. Silva, yes, he's from the University of Sri Jayawardenepura. He's from USJ Management Faculty and the Department of Accounting. And there's another student, Bandara, he's from USJ Management Faculty and Department of Accounting. Right. And if you think it's not good to have this no in front of those students who are not from, who do not qualify all these conditions, then you can simply remove these no's in front of those students' names who are not satisfying the condition. How you can remove? You simply remove this no and leave these two inverted commas, then enter, and then you can copy. Then you can see it's very attractive. Only people who satisfy the all the conditions are highlighted. You can clearly see who are the people satisfy all the conditions. So like this, you can compound between function, you can compound with more logical condition by incorporating and function to your if function. So if you look at the syntax, how you could apply and function to if function, it can be presented like this. You can start writing equal sign, then whole and function. You can incorporate up to 255 conditions. If all the conditions satisfied, it will give you this result. It will give you this parameter as the result. Otherwise, it will give you y as the result. So it's up to you to define what is x and what is y depending on your requirement. Right, so we'll try another simple example. Let's say you are given database relating to a test result, and particular set of students has set for 5 papers: accounting, economics, auditing, tax and IQ papers, and we need to give them final result, and we need to give them final result as pass if they have passed all the papers. If you have not passed all the papers, they will get final result as fail. So we can do it simply. We'll first write and function, and this cell must be equal pass. The same time, in addition, this cell must be equal to pass. Further, this cell must be equal to pass. In addition, this cell, we have more conditions. We have this cell must be equal to pass. Further, this is the last paper, IQ paper also they need to get through, must be passed. Okay, so as far as the first candidate George is concerned, he has satisfied all the conditions. That means for George, the conditions true, who have satisfied all the conditions. Right, so accordingly, George has satisfied all the conditions, and the Mary has satisfied as far as Pete is concerned true, Fatima is concerned true, Silva true and Christina, all they have satisfied the conditions. If you want to provide the result in an attractive manner, the result should be pass or fail. But with the AND function, you don't have that flexibility. So accordingly, if you want to get the result in an alternative mode, pass or fail, or good or bad, you need to incorporate this AND function with IF function. So we can cut or copy this function. I'll cut this function and write IF function. If for the first condition we can paste the what we have copied or cut. If all these conditions satisfied, we can say pass. Otherwise, fail. Close it back up. Enter. Right, so you can see we got the expected result. Right, like this we can incorporate more conditions, more logical conditions to your IF function. Right, so we'll now try to do one more example, activity number 2. Given below are conditions that a income earner should satisfy in paying commissions to local authority. A commission of 5% is payable if the income level is greater than or equal to 50,000 but less than or equal to 250,000. If the income is within the relevant range, the commission is to be paid on the amount that exceeds 50,000. Otherwise, commission is zero. Okay, now this situation we can incorporate compound conditions into your IF function. So we'll see how to do this. We'll do our model input area, then we have upper threshold limit, that is 250,000, and lower threshold limit, that is 50,000. Commission rate, percent. Okay, then input, let's say so then we can take the output. Commission okay. Right, so commission, how do you compute the commission? So commission should be paid only if two conditions satisfy. If the commission 5% is payable if the income level is greater than or equal 50,000 but less than or equal to 250,000. So you need to satisfy both conditions to pay the commission. Okay, we'll now see how to compute commission. So we'll first write n function and see what are the conditions you need to satisfy. For you to pay commission, the sale value must be greater than or equal to lower threshold level. You can make it fixed. And in addition, this sale value must be less than or equal to the upper threshold level. If all these conditions satisfied, you can pay commission. So here the income level we have incorporated, we have just put 200 hypothetical value. If the income level is 200,000, yes, it is within the relevant range, so condition satisfied, true, you need to pay commission. We try a small figure, let's say 40,000 income, then it's false because it's beyond the relevant range, so you don't need to pay commission. If it is more than 250, let's say 300,000, again false, you don't need to pay commission. So now we want to incorporate this n function to compute our commission. So n function can be combined with if function. You can cut this and write new formula with if function. You can write it like this and paste the n function you cut off. So this is the condition, logical condition for if function. We enter it as a single logical condition, but you know inside this AND function you have two logical conditions. If this logical condition satisfied, your parameter. If the condition is satisfied, you have to pay commission. So how do you compute commissions? Commission is equal this sale minus this lower threshold level, close the bracket, and times commission rate, otherwise commission should be zero. Now enter. So this time commission is zero because income level is above the relevant range. So if the income level, let's say 200,000, commission should be 7,500. The income level is 40,000, commission is zero. So like this we can incorporate AND function with if function to accommodate for more logical conditions.